Hey guys, welcome back to Oxygen Not Included, Clay's amazing space colony simulator extraordinaire. My name is Twitchi and we have been on the LZ Alpha for 1584 days now. The days are just racking up. Last time we sent our rocket out, let's press the star map button over here, out to this asteroid, this carbon asteroid. We got ourselves a bunch of study materials back, but this time, in fact, let's go back to the star map. I want to get some of this niobium. This will allow me, the main reason that I want it is, I'm not sure if you remember, but we've been having a little bit of trouble down here with our lava freezing, and the niobium will allow us to make some materials that we can actually just dunk straight in that lava. And what I want to be able to do is have a little system down here that's picking up this igneous rock and cutting things away. But first, before we can do any of that, we need to work on the research. The research, of course, all the way down here. We need to get ourselves a bunch of novice research done, which is just dirt. We've got dirt. That's fine. Get this advanced research done. That's just water. That's fine. That's just going to take some time. And of course, the interstellar research, which actually comes from the rocket. If we come over to here and have a look. Oh, they've actually all been moved now that I'm looking. When the rocket came back, it gave us a bunch of space science that we could study. I mean, over here we have the obelisk. This came from space. Ooh. But more importantly, in this virtual planetarium that we have built, we do have a whole bunch of data banks. So I just need to kind of wait and let these guys do their thing. We definitely need to get the research done. I definitely need to tidy up the floor here. And I will see you guys in a little bit when this entire workforce are going to work hard at getting the research done. No, it's just one person, let's be honest. Which leads me thinking we are actually going to have to bring in another scientist at some point. He's our rocket guy. If we go and have a look at the skills, I don't think anybody else is even close to being set up for rockets. I mean, Cubic's got some exosuit training. I mean, a lot of people actually have exosuit training. But when it comes to the research skill line, it's only Forrest. Forrest is the only one who's got anything on there. And we don't even have anybody who likes to do that. It says two. Ooh, here we go. Jelly, you have some... All right, well, welcome to the research division. All right, let's see what happens when we do that. I think this is going to backfire in our face because, of course, Jelly is the man that goes around and tidies up. So maybe we need another gopher? I mean, they did just go vroom at us, so let's do it. Why not? Okay, Jelly, we're going to turn up your research priorities just a little bit here. We're going to say yes rather than the big nose. And let's have a look down here and see if we've got somebody we can bring in. Operating, doctoring, supplying, suit wearing, digging. All right, almost none of these are what I want. What I really would like is a researching supplier. Actually, I'm going to go do this a different way for Jelly's priorities. We're going to turn his research up very high and the supplying down a little bit more, because once all the research is done, he'll just default to the supplies anyway, right? I hope so. Because that's the way we had it at the time. He was doing the supplying and then defaulting to research, which means he would never get to research because there's always supply jobs to be done. Oh, Jenny's away. Oh, and now Forrest is away. This is crazy. I've never seen them use this before. That is amazing. Literally a virtual planetarium. But why are they projecting it on the wall if he's got 3D goggles on? Surely that's totally redundant. You wouldn't need them up on the wall at all because he can't see past the goggles. Is this just for the outside observer's benefit? I mean, obviously it is just for the player's benefit because this is a game we're playing, but trying to get into the meta of this here, why are they there? I think we're going to need a third researcher. It's almost certain we need a third researcher. We need someone else to work on this. The fact that Forrest is going in the virtual planetarium makes sense. He is the big boy there, so let's see what's going on with these others. The novice research is very far behind, but we're literally watching these ones tick up as we go. We might even have this by the beginning of next cycle. Probably not, now that I think about it. We're going to get some of the novice research done, and then nighttime will be called, because that is the curse of my life in this game. I know at some point I could set up a scheduling system that means we have some overnight workers, but we've not got a big enough colony for that. I kind of feel like 14, even 15 is not enough to be splitting up their work schedules. We could, don't get me wrong, we really could, but I don't know. I care for these little bundles of code. No, I didn't realize we had 200 interstellars to do. Even longer, especially as nighttime has actually been called now. One of the side jobs I'm going to get to when we start clearing this lava out is to get all this ethanol out. I need to get underneath so we can start draining, just start pulling some of it away. And then if it's not carbon dioxide, which is what I want to have down there, we'll pump all the gases out somewhere else. Don't really care where that goes. It's a waste. Oh, look, Jelly's got stuck in the never-ending animation here. He'll pick up a little bit of dirt, then he'll drop it off, and then he'll do the tiniest little bit of research, and then he'll pick up some more. Someone must have interrupted him there. Literally did, like, 5 of research in that time. Oh, it was horrific. We have run into great problems. There are indeed some serious issues. As you can see, we've only got to the interstellar research of 179 out of 200. This is a fair bit short of getting all of that we needed, and the data banks have run dry. We actually need to send off our little research rocket again, which is a little bit sad because I ripped the command capsule off of it. We're kind of hoping not to need it again. I was hoping that we could just rip this middle one out and put the put a cargo capsule in there instead. But no, we're going to have to send Forrest off on another perilous journey into the great beyond. The question, of course, is do we send them to the one where we've already been to, where I think we only need 2 more research from it, or do we send it to this one where we can have 3 entire researches? I think that's what we're going to do, actually. And then we'll find out what this world is composed of and if there's any artifacts. Why is this telling me no artifacts, despite the fact that I did indeed pick up an obelisk here? I don't know. It's a new day, it's a new dawn, as we can see with the light going up. I'm waiting for this command capsule to get built. Is anybody on the priorities? Matt, Frank, no, Mimi is coming along to help out here. As soon as she does whatever job it is she's trying to, I bet she's just having breakfast. Selfish, I tell you, selfish. Okay, Mimi, finally building that capsule. I hope you had a wonderful breakfast. That should be great. All right, the command capsule is unassigned, of course, that's fine. Missing atmosphere suit. It's right down here. It's right down here. How do we make sure that is a thing? Anyway, Forrest, could you get your little duplicate butt in there? Thank you. Oh, no, he says he's ready to go. He's not ready to go. You lie. You very much lie. Like, I don't think there's any fuel in there. There's a whole bunch of things that I'm like, no. Yeah, ore gate. But you shouldn't be. Oh, no. There we go. Brave space station. For some reason, it reset to meteor showers. Why are you on? Oh, no, you've opened because there's an incoming meteor shower. Oh, no. No, don't do this. Close the door. Close the door. Close the door. Okay, the doors are closing. Great. How's our power situation doing? Not bad. Okay, we're fine. We're fine. We should be saved from this. Ooh, why did that happen? Oh, that's a little inconvenient. I wonder if we can update it to a bunker tile. Okay, Forrest just went and ran into there. That's cool. Missing atmosphere suit is a problem. If we put that up on 9 and see if anybody's going to get onto it. It's right here, right at the bottom. I don't know who's going to actually come and pick it up, though. Someone was running up here to deliver the suit, but unfortunately, nighttime got called. So in that time, I am going to pump out some gases here. I want to try and move a whole bunch of this steam down. And also, I just noticed that we do indeed have a break in the pipe, so I'm going to fill that up. And hopefully, we're going to be getting some liquids coming up this way. Beautiful. Look at that weird coloration down the bottom where we've got an autosave running. Ooh, weird. Okay, nice. That must have been the material. Yeah, look at that. It's the materials overview. What's it doing down there? What's it doing down there? Anyway, we're going to pump in some more water. We're going to pump some more steam into here. We're at 19, 20 kilos. That's pretty good. And I'm just waiting for someone, just for someone to come along and put this atmosphere suit in before we select a destination. I mean, surely the fact that Forrest was wearing one anyway should really sort of balance that out. No? Okay, Dr. Captain Subs. Sir Dr. Captain Subs. Thank you very, very much. We're going to the star map. We're going to... Oh, too far for this rocket. We need to get more gases in there. Definitely should have started steaming this rocket up way earlier than this. Can we, however, click the star map now? Are we getting even closer? I wonder how much steam we actually need. I'm sure there's a calculator out there that I could go and plug some numbers into, but I'm literally pumping the steam, so I might as well just keep checking, right? I've just noticed the fill gauge on the rocket engine. Let's zoom right in here. You see this blue line coming up here? Okay, that's cool. That directly correlates to how much we've got in there. So a full tank is 900, as we know. Okay, still need more. Starting to get mildly concerned about the temperature drop. Eventually, we're not going to have any steam in here. It's just going to be water. Okay, so I have selected the asteroid here. It should tell me when this stops being destination beyond reach, right? That's my plan. Also, I really hope nothing else is going wrong in the base while we're watching this for like days on end. Ah, it changed. I was stuffing my face and it changed. Okay, that's fine. Let's turn this off over here. And let's say goodbye to Forrest. We click that. Launch mission. Off he goes. Away he goes. Always takes forever for these rockets to get going. Is he waiting for the more fuel before he goes? I'm not sure. The gantry has been... Oh, no. Bart, missing gantry. Now, I understand that the launch path is blocked. I get that. But the missing gantry thing shouldn't be an issue, right? Okay, hopefully when Miss has dug all this out, we should be ready to go again. Do you not like that? Is that not for you? Launch mission, away it goes. Are we going? We are actually going. Okay, that's great. I was getting a little bit worried there. Yellow alert, we broke the gantry again. But we retracted it. What? Why is that a thing? How are we supposed to do this then? Well, it got repaired, but I'm wondering whether I just kind of want to move it back one. Do you reckon that would work? Let's deconstruct it now. No, not yellow alert. Yeah, let's deconstruct it one right now and see if we can move it back. Hopefully the rocket won't come back in this time. Mimi really is the heavy lifter when it comes to the building nowadays. It used to be Mad Frank. Now he's... I don't even know what he's up to. The big question is, does he even interact with this? We'll find out. Okay, gantry in place. We'll just have to see if the rocket can still use it. Oh, I've just found out that up here, they give you a little timer. We are currently at 0.8 of 3 cycles, 72%. Maybe it's the 0.8 left to go. Okay, that's cool. That's really cool. I was beginning to wonder how we told, and there we go. We tell on the star map. Looking at the star map later, 0.3 of 3 cycles. Yeah, that's definitely how much is left. Okay, the scanner is saying incoming object. The star map says 100%. Where are you? Come on, little rocket. I need you to get you back. We need that science so we can actually get on with what we're supposed to be doing this episode. And here he comes. All right, beautiful, beautiful. Now, does this swing back? I noticed that it hasn't got destroyed. Double thumbs up for that. That swings back. Forrest teleports out. Did you guys watch that? He was just like, bloop, gone. He's still got a sign, but let's unassign him. Yeah, there we go. All right, cool, cool. That didn't work last time we tried to do that, but he's going to grab all the data and he's off. And he's off. Talking of, let's have a look at the star map over here. I don't really want to select. How do I abort the mission? Anyway, we can see here we've got 3 of the researches done. Beautiful. Oh, well, not the research. The materials, the data banks brought back. And we got isoresin and niobium definitely going here for our cargo run. But first, the data. It must be researched. Hey guys, I've just realized from this star patterns, we could probably try and figure out where they are in the universe. Like, if anybody happened to be like doing an astrophysics degree out there or something, you could probably figure out what the different views of these stars would be from different locations in the galaxy and then try and work out where they are. Because they totally didn't just draw these patterns at these constellations at random, did they? No. Yeah, that's a fun project if someone's up for it. All right, we're just waiting for the novice research, which means we're waiting for the dirt. A couple of episodes ago, we discovered that the ethanol in the petroleum generators here were getting a little bit too hot, and that's where most of the ethanol gas was coming from. And I think I know finally what has caused it, and it may have been me trying to be smart, but once again, this has backfired on me. We've got this nice little system up here where it collects all the small little ethanol bubbles together, puts them into big packets, and then fires them off down when we've got 4 entire ones ready to go. But this means that there's an awful lot of ethanol being delivered at once, and that's just sat around waiting to get warm rather than being used. Do you think if we actually just completely destroyed this process here, we'd be better off? I think we might be, guys. Ah, interesting that we've got ethanol leakage over here. Where's this come from? What's happened? What has happened? Sweepy, do your job. Must have come down this way somewhere. Oh, I think Jelly with his weird method might get us up to the research we've been waiting for. Ah, beautiful. Okay, this has opened up a whole bunch of stuff in the rocketry. I say a whole bunch of stuff. It opens up the cargo pod, and this is exactly what I want to put. Let's put it up the top here. Let's do that, shall we? Hopefully it's the right size. It looks about the right size next to it. Yeah, top and bottom. That should be able to just replace straight away. And then we can go to these other asteroids again and get ourselves a whole bunch of cargo materials. At some point, we probably want to think about having a second rocket on this side. That way we can have a cargo one and a research one. And we're probably going to come down quite far down this way as well with extra modules. Because, of course, as we work further up the star map, we're going to get more and more information about stuff that we want to just go and get. So with the cargo line of research started, I suppose we should also start the solid fuel combustion, and it does it straight away. Ah, no, I need to do jetpacks. I've not bothered. We've never needed them. Rocket, like ladders are really good. Like, really good. got a small problem up by the Rodriguez, and I don't actually know how it's happened at all. We've had a Wolframite break. The only thing I can think is that we liquefied our oxygen? Surely not. Surely not. The temperature needed for that is incredibly low, and the temperature in here in the hydrogen is like 30 degrees, so I don't see how that would have happened. We've had something mixed in here at some point, haven't we? We must have. I bet it's been some ethanol. Anyway, because of this weird situation, we're going to have to try and break into here, but ideally without losing any hydrogen. So I'm going to move this door down one so I can put a tile under here and then try and make a little bit of a liquid lock coming through this way. It's not going to be great. It's not going to be pretty, but it is hopefully going to get us in there to fix it. Okay, the filthy deed is done. I've broken it open. We've got a water lock. Immediately, Luna was that has come through and fixed it. We're going to seal it up. We're going to never talk about this again. It was a dark history, a dark day in the colony's history. On the other side of the base, the side of progress, we are moving on and, realizing we're a little bit more vulnerable than we thought we were. Let's just try and build some of these quickly out there. That's throwing me a little bit off, if I'm to be honest with you guys. We've been pumping some gas down and into here. Steam engine is a go, or at least it is ready to be a go. I didn't realize we're going to have a conveyor receptacle coming out of this. I was kind of expecting it just to drop stuff on the floor. Do you know what I'm going to do with it? That's right, I'm going to drop stuff on the floor. Ooh-wee. My plan was to build the molecular forge down in the big big sauna block down here, but it's big, it's huge, it's massive. We might end up having to dig out a little area over here, but even then I'm wondering whether this might still interfere. I think we're gonna have to build this place its own dedicated area. Okay, Mimi came along and put in the last of the conveyor rail. We should just about be ready to go. No astronaut assigned. Forrest, if you could, please. And we're going to send you to this... of course, we can't go yet because we don't have enough fuel. Okay, overnight we had a meteor shower, but we also managed to fill this all the way up and we're still too far away. I don't understand. Let's go to the star map. Why is it too far for this rocket? What is the problem? So my guess would be that the cargo bay is too heavy. Okay, we've got two options for what to do, and I think I'm gonna take the laziest of the two. I am gonna go ahead and pop this one here. We could have made another rocket specifically for the cargo. Instead, I'm just gonna make this one short. Hello, why are you overheating? What's going on here? We got some petroleum, we've got some vacuum. Okay, all right, the actual problem here. Was there another one just starting up a problem? Doesn't look like it. It might just be this one. Let's deal with that, shall we? Empty pipe contents, this one right here. Luna should be along any moment to help out with this. Okay, we've got a little packet of petroleum in the box. Let's now ask Luna to come. Where's she going? I don't know where she's going. I got distracted by moving the rocket, and I think someone's stolen the petroleum and run it down to the bottom here, because we've got, is it this one? Does this one take, but it wasn't set to sweep. What about this one? This is sweep only as well. Where did it go? You know, I'm not sure where it's went. I've gone around and checked all my bottle emptiers, and none of them were set up to empty without a sweep order. I'm not sure what's going on here. Okay, she got to it this time, and we've dropped some petroleum down here, but I've got a feeling that almost all of it just vented straight out to space. Yes, indeed. Okay, that should be a wonderful. So I can now turn this back on. Oh, please, duplicates, come and turn this alarm off. We also seem to be unable to get this last little bit of conveyor rail that I've been asked to make, so I'm going to see whether making this whole gantryway here will work. I'm also going to hook it up to the automation grid to pull it back. I think that's kind of important. Oh, we just fixed the robo miner as well. Great. Okay, it took us a while, but we finally got this sorted. Indeed, the gantry did solve our problems. Forrest, could you launch it? We still can't. Oh no, why? So obviously the need for the solid fuel thrusters is quite great. We're still waiting for the last bits of this novice research to pop through, but I feel like this is going to be forcing me back to space. I got a feeling if we come down and have a look here, we don't have the full 200 needed. So I'm going to take the hint. We're going to rebuild this back up into a double science and we're just going to go. Okay, let's take the hint. We've had the jetpacks come in for the research. I'm literally never going to use those. I really don't think so. Command capsule's doing a weird. It's not being selectable down below. I'm going to just go ahead and try and use it anyway and see what we can do here. I want to go to this one. Why not? Let's just pick that one. I'm not sure what it's going to say. What's the problem? Spaceship 3. Can we do it? Can we do it? Doesn't look like we can. Why? Ah, the atmosphere suit, of course. Always that atmosphere suit. Thank you, Mimi. Great. Now we just have the problem of why this won't be showing up here. So the reason its launch path is blocked is because the doors are locked. But we need to be able to get this to pick up when the ship is returning. I think I'm going to try deconstructing and put it back down and see what happens. Whatever happens, Forrest is away. Coming back with some science, I hope. That's what we're waiting for. This one also cannot. I think I'm going to have to do a save and reload. Okay, it turns out, yes, doing a reload brings it up onto the scanners. That's good, because I kind of need that. The doors are opening, and that means the rocket is on its way back. Let's have a look up here. 93%. Oh, yes, indeed. It's a little early to be opening the doors, if you ask me. That's a little... We could go for a finer margin there. We've got like 0.1 of a cycle where some asteroids could come careening through. But whilst we're doing that, let's go around and talk about a few things that have been going wrong in the background. Over here, the steam overpressured. I don't know what happened. This was the wrong way around or something. So we have just kind of swapped it over to get the steam pumping out. I think we have backed up a little bit here, but I think we'll be okay once it starts cooling down. The main problem was that the overflow is not working. We'll try and figure out how to fix that in a moment. The other problem that we've got is on this F6 screen, we've got a bit of an ethanol problem. Look, it's there. It's mostly in my polluted water line now, which I don't know how we're going to sort out, but sort it out we must. Oh, I've just had a thought. I asked. No, Luna has not come down here to empty these out yet. Okay, let's have a look and let's see what's going on here. So I've asked her to come down, but as there's polluted water, we're going to stop her doing this one. She's going to come across to the next one. That says it contains polluted water. Let's not do that one then. Why aren't you a good boy? What's going on? It's got everything it needs. I don't know why it's not doing stuff. I mean, it's got some ethanol as well, but surely that should go. A few of these actually have vast amounts of ethanol behind them. Let's let this one get emptied out. I'm even going to let the polluted water go just so we can get that next ethanol packet. Okay, let's let that one go. Oh, there's another there. Do I want to just let them all through? Let's just do it. Where is the liquids going? They're going at the top. Okay, that's kind of fine. That's kind of fine. We'll find somewhere of dumping our polluted water. Are you the only one left? Are you the only one left? That would be very helpful. I mean, actually, no, there's vast amounts. We should put a sorting system on here. Okay, a quick hack of a system here. Let's just quickly turn all these up because it is quite important that we filter all this stuff out of here. We're just going to filter the ethanol. And because I've been facing this problem before, we've got an ethanol filter at the top here, which is dumping down into this region. So that's going to get that sorted. Let's go back up to space, though. And the rocket is back, which means if we're very sharp, we should actually have... Oh, he's not here yet. Where is he? Oh, I know where he is. Let's get him out of there. Okay, so now Forrest should be moving down towards the virtual planetarium so we can get the solid fuel boosters underway. Because it turns out, much like some other games we play, if we can't get far enough, we need to add some more boosters. One thing that I've noticed is that we sent 6 science pods to the carbon asteroid over here, but we've only had 5 returns. And now I'm guessing that means that is the maximum we're going to get from that. So the only thing we ever actually want to send back to here is indeed a cargo rocket. Do you know what else might also help? If we start analyzing a few of these things up here as well. Oh, we can't do both together. Okay, we'll start with this one on the right. You know, earlier on when I said I was going to take the easy way of launching a cargo rocket, it turned out to be horrendously complex. Well, I'm going to take the other option, which it turns out might be the lazy option, where I'm just going to build a steam engine, a cargo pod, and a command capsule, and just send that off on its own and see if that works better. Working on the edge of the screen is tight, though. Okay, we seem to be a little bit limited by the amount of steel that we have on hand, and of course the thing that is holding us back from steel is the amount of lime that we have on hand. Then the thing holding us back with the amount of lime is we don't have any poke shell or fossils. So I thought I'd come through here with my mineral selection on and see that there actually is a whole host of fossils to be going to get. So I'm going new expedition time. Okay, the fossil digging team have come along and done their magic. It's a little bit hard to reach this one here, but we've got some ladders going into place, so that should do wonders. The next thing I want to know is who's coming along to do the deliveries. This one here, let's have a look. Errands, anybody? I mean, Jelly's doing his work, but a lot of people are saying they can't do it. I think I'm going to just hit that for a moment and see how long it takes everyone to deliver everything up here. Oh, there's a better way we can do it, actually. There's a better way. I'm going to leave that on 9. But over here, this one also, I believe, is this where we keep it? Raw mineral, fossil? Let's get everyone doing that, shall we, instead? So we're now at the point where people are coming along and making a whole bunch of lime for us. If I bring this up, you can see that the lime is being shipped down the rail all the way down. Oh, it's a long way down to here where we drop it down and get it ready for making steel. Now, we could wait. We could wait for long enough for the cargo bay to be available for us to be made. But I think what I'm going to do to save us a little bit of time is deconstruct two of these research modules and go in like and use their steel instead. Sorry. I mean, literally, as I've been sat here, the cargo bay has become available and we haven't knocked down either of these research modules, so I think we'll be okay. Well, this sure has taken its time. Many days waiting for the dirt to come in. It turns out if we are just trying to get ourselves on the way to like casual day-to-day living, we've got more than enough dirt to deal with things. But when we are intensively working at stuff like this, just not enough, just not enough. Okay, we've got our solid fuel combustion in. It turns out we're doing the hydrogen straight away. I don't remember clicking on that, but we have clicked on that anyway. So this one over here, it cannot make it. If we come up here, we can see that it can make it to 9,341 kilometers. And where we actually need to be going is 1,000, which is just 10,000, sorry, which is, it's very painful. It's very painful. So I'm hoping that with the ability to put some solid fuel boosters on there, oh, struggled with that one. We should be able to get a little bit further. So the first thing I'm going to do, destroy this steam engine that I've been pumping gas into. I really wanted to check the numbers. Totally wasn't that I forgot that it couldn't make it. I mean, I'm assuming the engine needs to be on the bottom. I don't think I can put the booster underneath. That would be a bit weird. Wow, look at all the steam go. We spent thermal energy on that. It wasn't our thermal energy. It came from the space, but we spent it anyway. Okay, so this guy burns refined iron, falls from the sky, and oxalite. Now, the oxalite might be a bit of an issue. If we come into the refinement and find the oxalite maker, oxalite refinery, this guy takes in oxygen and gold and a whole bunch of power and outputs some oxalite. I think we could probably make this guy up here. We'll set up a little cooling block. We've got a cooling block. Okay, yeah, we could probably do it right here, in fact. Okay, I'm hoping this won't overwhelm the cool pit that we've got up there. I'm just going to dump the oxalite refinery. I had it a second ago. There we go. Glass forge, oxalite refinery, right here, one down. I thought I want to go one down, but nobody's come along to break the stuff yet. So I'm going to pop that. Oh, I mean, if we do it over here, we could maybe get two. Let's try that. Let's pop that one there. So that's going to get all made with the materials that have already been brought up because I put it down once before. I went, no, that's not right. Also running out of plastic again. Okay, so I'm drawing power off of the grid over here, feeding it into the oxalite refinery. That is also feeding off of the oxygen that's going up to the telescope. So we got those two, and we're also needing a little bit of gold, which I've gone and turned the steel production of the refinery into gold. And all of this is now being put together, and we're dropping oxalite on the floor. Thankfully, because we are... Oh, what do you mean no power? Oh, that's no fun. But because we are... Oh no, we're venting. This is bad. I was hoping that would be pressurized enough. I am going to go ahead and put a gas vent right here, and then it should mean that we get up fully to pressure and we won't lose so much. I was kind of hoping we wouldn't lose any. But just as downtime gets called, I get to show you that we've got a solid fuel thruster here. We're just waiting. I don't know, do people need to deliver stuff? I don't know how it works. Okay, so we've put the vent in and we have stopped emitting oxygen. Okay, that's great. We're going to start building up a good stockpile here. I'm wondering whether I want to put like a storage room. Yeah, let's do it. What does it cost me, hey? So this doesn't require any duplicant interaction. It just makes the stuff all on its own. Okay, that's pretty cool. Oh no. So I asked Miss to come up here to dig out the bunker doors. It's just an easier option than putting these over the top at the moment. And there was a little bit of regolith here. Oh, I caught her out overnight. Someone made a mess. I was like, oh no, what's that? And she now has to walk around in her environment suit filled with urine. Oh, it's horrible. Okay, so we got a full tank of fuel, but they don't seem to want to drop off any of the oxalite and iron. I'm not sure why. I'm wondering whether if we go and assign Forest and put a pilot in the command capsule, whether they'll then go and deliver the goods. I don't know. The thing that confuses me is putting on yellow alert still doesn't put anyone here. Got plenty of iron. Oh, I wonder how much oxalite it uses. Maybe that's it. Okay, so now we've got this delivery notification. They're not over here, but I'm told that we need 400 kilograms of each. We've got more than enough iron. Let's have a look in here. We've got just over 400 kilograms. I did a little bit of a reshuffle down here. This line now also feeds into this bridge. It still has priority to feed the line down this way, then to the oxalite, and then finally it will feed out over this way. I noticed we were losing a lot of oxygen and the oxalite was not being built fast enough, so I was like, let's do that instead. No one wants to deliver. No one. I'm not sure why. Operate and supply. Let's see who we can give operate and supply to. I want to give it to Jelly because he's the guy who does most of the supplying. Farm supply, Gristleberry. No mention of storing the stuff in the rocket. I'm very confused. It's not the fact that I need to put it in with conveyor rail. That's what kind of something I was thinking. No liquid or gas ports other than the steam. How? I bet I know. I bet it's the gantry. Almost has to be, right? Almost has to be. I need to run this down here. Oh, why won't it go through? Okay, I see the problem. Okay, gantry's in place, suddenly populated lists. Oh, we just had delivery of oxalite. Beautiful. Now waiting on the iron. Oh, he just went all off on his own. Oh, I was trying to figure out why the gantry had gone back and why people... Oh, that's cool. All the deliveries have been made and going to the star map. Oh, our cargo rocket is on the way. Oh, wow, yes. Well, the doors have opened up, so I'm expecting the rocket to be coming down any second. Let's have a quick look on the star map. 98%. I'm not sure whether looking at the star map pauses time or not. Let's have a look. We're just passing the little crater. I'm just gonna hold on for a second or two. Let's see how long we can just let this sit for a little while, and then we come back. And no, the time had not advanced at all. So that's something to bear in mind. If you're waiting for your rocket to come back, don't keep checking your star map, else you will... Space mission complete. Ah, oh, cool. Does that come in every time? Don't keep checking your star map, else it will end up, like, causing you a wrong one. Okay, let's come down here. We've got rocket thruster damage on these guys. Why didn't they turn off when this said, hey, open the doors? Because we've got a lot of melted stuff here. I don't know. So there are problems. But anyway, we are dropping some stuff here. Look at that. We've got some isoresin and some niobium. Even some diamond, some coal, refined carbon. It's a smorgasbord of all wonderful, amazing stuff. Oh, look at this. What's this? We found an old X-ray as well. But I'm afraid we're going to have to check all of this stuff out next time because all of this has taken a much, much longer than I thought it would do. I will see you next time when we are going to set up a molecular forge and try and figure out how to deal with all this stuff. I want things that I can submerge in lava, but I will see you then, or when we're gonna deal with that. Bye.